Now, tomorrow evening we'll know who is the next Australian of the Year. This morning we're hearing from a finalist for that role who has an inspirational story to tell. Kate Swaffer was diagnosed with dementia at the age of 49. Doctors advised her to drop everything and prepare for life in a nursing home, but they underestimated her courage. She's the first Australian full member of the World Dementia Council, and she works hard on behalf of millions of people around the world who have dementia, among them nearly 400,000 Australians. Ida Buttrose met Kate for this very special interview.
You're one hell of a gutsy woman, Kate Swaffer. What is it like to live with dementia?
Gosh, living with dementia some days is terrifying and difficult and sad. And then there are lots of days now where I see living with dementia as my third greatest gift in my whole life.
People would find it difficult to understand that terminology. In what way is it a gift?
Being told you've got a disease that, number one, is terminal, that, number two, you're likely to lose memories about your family, your friends, your own life, memories about who you are and who you were. That's given me a clarity about life that I really didn't have before.
But you won't necessarily lose all your ability, will you?
I mean, I have no idea. You don't know
because everybody's dementia journey is different.
Yeah.
But it doesn't necessarily happen that way.
No, that's right. So my handwriting has become quite difficult. So there's a lot of invisible disabilities that people without dementia don't ever see, so I travel with laminated sheets in case I forget what to do in the bathroom in a hotel, for example, and to make sure I've packed everything when I'm leaving.
So they're reminder sheets?
They're reminder sheets. And, you know, initially to stick them up around my house, I felt embarrassed and mildly ashamed about that. But then I thought, well, I wear reading glasses. I'm not worried about wearing reading glasses. Why am I so worried about laminated sheets? That help me stay independent.
How important is your husband, Peter? You refer to him in helping you maintain your lifestyle, but you refer to him as your backup brain.
Yeah, I do. He dislikes being called a carer because he said, I cared for you long before you had dementia. Otherwise, I wouldn't have married you. So he and many carers, family carers that I've talked to say that label in some way strips them of all their other roles in that person's life. So whether it's a daughter or a lover or a sister or a brother. So I nicknamed him my bub, which is my backup brain, and he only steps in if it's dangerous. So because I have this strange dyslexia and see things back to front, if I'm crossing a busy one-way road, I'll see the arrow back to front. So I'll look the way where there's no traffic coming and step out in front of traffic. So that's the only time he steps in without me asking.
Knowing what you know now, I mean, how would you go about changing it? What sort of changes would you like to see happen?
Well, when I was diagnosed, I was told by the whole of the healthcare sector that I should give up work, that I should give up study, it would be too stressful, that I should get my end of affairs in order.
End of life?
End of life affairs in order, and that I should get acquainted with aged care. And within 6 months of diagnosis, it was recommended I start going to aged care daycare a day a month to get used to it. Think about that.
They underestimated you, didn't they?
Well, I wasn't particularly keen on the idea. But then I started thinking about it with a nurse's hat on. So I have a unique set of eyes, having been a nurse as well. And I went, well, if I'd had a brain injury from a stroke or a road accident, would they have told me to go home and die via aged care? Of course not. They would have offered me rehabilitation. But then I was at university and I talked to, well, often the lecturers were a bit younger than me because I was a mature age student. So do you think I should give up university? And they said, well, you're early stage dementia, you're not ready for aged care, why don't we just treat you like a student with disabilities, like anybody else with dyslexia or other learning difficulties? So that was a big turning point for me. Treat the symptoms of dementia as disabilities, demand the support that you have a human right to, but the world doesn't yet offer us. So what I would do if I was diagnosing someone with dementia, I would immediately send them for a disability assessment and then set them up with disability support to stay as independent for as long as possible.
If you should become the National Australian of the Year on January 25, will this be one of the issues that you will raise with Australians in an effort to make Australia more dementia-friendly?
I'll definitely raise the human rights and disability rights as an issue. I'm definitely mildly terrified of that thought as well, because I actually see it as a huge responsibility if I'm given that opportunity to have a louder voice.
You know, you might be a bit hesitant about what lies ahead should you become Australian of the Year, but you yourself are such an inspirational woman. Look what you can do even if you have dementia.
I just see myself as a kid from a farm trying to do the right thing, Ita. Seriously.
What a brave woman. Wow. And Kate Crawford is speaking to Ita, and Kate has published two fantastic books. They're on your screen now. And for good advice on dementia, you can always call the National Helpline, which is 1-800-100-500.